Hello guys, with the new upcoming Superman movie releasing in theaters this July, let's learn how to make this flying scene in Blender and After Effects. So let's jump right into it. First, I'm getting the Superman 3D model from Sketchfab, link in description. And then I switch the head with David Koren's web. I'm using Keen tool to match the 3D head feature to photo reference. And finally, project the photo to the 3D model to texture it. I also adjust the 3D model with proportional editing and swap the S symbol to match the James Gunn Superman reference. As for the rigging, I download it from Mixamo, append the rig, and adjust it to the Superman 3D model. You can parent the 3D model to the rig with automatic weight. Next, you can select the bone, then the 3D model to go to weight painting to make sure the rig influences the 3D model properly. Now let's get going and model the cape. You can start by adding a plane, scale it down on x-axis and enlarge the end part. Click Ctrl-R to add loop cut to the cape. And with proportional editing turned on, grab the front middle part of the cape so it goes nicely around Superman's neck. Next, you will need to select both the front handle of the cape. Make a new vertex group called Pin and assign the selected handles to the vertex group. After the cape modeling is done, you can go ahead and texture both sides of the cape. First, you need to UV unwrap the cape. Here, I'm using Project from View. Assign image texture to the principal BSDF for the cape's backside. Then, duplicate both the principal and image texture node. Change the image texture to the front side of the cape. Combine both principal BSDF node with mix shader. Add geometry node and use backfacing as the factor input. With the 3D model good to go, we can move on to adjusting the pose of Superman. Here I want Superman flies while looking up. Next, we can add cloud simulation to the cape. You can play around with the settings such as vertex mass and damping. Here, I want to use some preset that Blender already provided, like silk. Go to the shape tab and select the pin group that we have assigned earlier so the cape doesn't fall off. You also need to add collision to the Superman 3D model so the cape won't clip into the Superman 3D model. You can see that the cape looks low poly-ish. We can fix that by adding subdivision surface modifier and press W to shade smooth. Then you can add wind to make the cape flaps and crank up the strength. If you have satisfied with the result, select the cape and bake the simulation. Finally, you can add camera. Go to the angle that you want and press Ctrl-Alt-0 to align the view to the camera. As for the lighting, I'm using HDRI lighting. In the World tab, you can add texture coordinate and mapping node by pressing Ctrl-T. Make sure you have Node Wrangler add-on installed. Now, you can adjust the lighting angle by changing the rotation value in mapping node. For the render setting, I'm using 1920 by 1080 with 24fps. And then, go to the render properties under film tab and check the transparent option as we only need to render Superman with transparent background. Make sure the output is PNG file with RGBA setting selected. Choose where your output folder is and click Render Animation. We're done now with Blender. Let's head to After Effects and import the Superman PNG sequence. right-click on the file and make sure it's in 24 fps. Now make it a 3D layer and create a new camera. Import a sky image with high resolution for the background. Make it a 3D layer as well and put it far in the back and adjust the scale. You can then animate the position of the sky layer and move it downward. Make sure the sky layer moves slowly because it is far away from the camera. Adjust the scale of Superman layer and make it move slowly upward. Now let's add some cloud animation. Import image of cloud on transparent or black background and put it into a new comp. Make the composition 25 frame long with 920 by 1080 resolution. Here I'm masking each cloud separately with pen tool. Scale it up and then animate them downward in 10 frames. Set the blending mode to screen, adjust the position, move them in timeline so they will show up variably in time. Keep on duplicating them to make the cloud keep showing up. Check the motion blur and you have yourself some cloud animation. Drag the cloud comp into the main comp and make it 3D layer as well. Set the blending mode to screen and reduce the opacity from the cloud comp. Duplicate the cloud comp several times to fit the preview timeline. Make some variation in the clouds between the front and behind Superman. Some details that you can add is smoke trail. You can create a new comp with 1080 by 1920 resolution. And then make a new black solid. Add fractal noise. Bump up the contrast to around 400, the brightness to around 30, and complexity to 6. Animate the offset turbulence and crank up the Y value. Then alt-click the offset turbulence keyframe and add expression, loop out duration, cycle type. Alt-click on evolution 2 and add expression, time, asterisk, 70. Then add some mask with pen tool to shape the smoke trail. Add roughen edge to make the mask edge look like smoke, with the border set to around 30, scale to 43, and complexity to 6. Animate offset turbulence on y-axis and add expression, loop out duration, cycle type. Also alt-click on the evolution keyframe and add expression, time, asterisk, 60. Now, add the smoke trail comp to the main comp, make it a 3D layer, set the blending mode to screen, move this layer to the back of Superman, turn down the opacity, and parent it to the Superman layer. Then you can create a new comp, drag the original comp to the new one, alt-click the position keyframe, and add wiggle expression with 8 for frequencies and 6 for amplitude. Scale the comp a little bit so there's no empty space. Now let's add some lens dirt. Here I have some image of camera lens dirt overlay. Adjust the position, scale, and rotation. Set the blending mode to screen, and then you can animate the opacity. From 0, go to the next 2 frames, set it to 100, then the next 2 frames to 50, then 100 again, and lastly to 0. Then you can select all the keyframes, right click, and toggle hold keyframe. Do the same thing to other lens dirt overlay. For the final touch, let's color grade the video with Lumetri color to boost the image. Here in Hue versus Saturation tab, I'm boosting the saturation of the red color. And finally, add some vignette. That's all for the tutorial. Let me know in the comments if you have some question, and have a great day.